Hello, and in today's ATmega328P programming, we are going to be covering the watchdog timer. Now, let's have a look at the schematic. We have two LEDs connected to PD7 and PD6 on the D port. These LEDs I'm going to run into a sequence where both are flashing and then individually flashing, and then I'm going to lock up the CPU so that we can have a watchdog timer trigger. Let's have a look at the datasheet. In the datasheet in section 10.6, we have the watchdog system reset. Now, basically, it just says it generates a clock pulse that will reset the ATmega328P once the watchdog timer has expired. Then we have section 10.8, which is the watchdog timer itself. Then we have the feature list. So it has a clocked from a separate on-chip oscillator. So this just means your internal oscillator and your external oscillator, which we are using on the ATmega328P, is completely separate. So it is a completely independent circuit from the entire internals of the chip. And then we have three operation modes. We have interrupt mode, we have system reset, and we have interrupt and system reset, and then you of course just have disabled. And then we have a selectable timeout period from 16 milliseconds to 8 seconds, and then we have a hardware fuse to turn on the watchdog timer, which is the VDT on for a failsafe mode. Now we have an overview of the watchdog timer. Here again they say the VDT is a timer counting cycles of a separate on-chip oscillator. So it's a completely different oscillator that runs on a 128 kilohertz oscillator. So the minimum timing is 128 divided by 2, so 64 kilohertz, and then you can convert that over to a time, which is, I believe, the 16 milliseconds they talk about. I'm not sure about that. Then they just say the VDT gives an interrupt or a system reset when the counter reaches a given timeout value. In normal operation mode, it is required that the system uses the VDR, watchdog timer reset instruction. So this is an assembler instruction that we need to use to restart the counter before the timeout value is reached. So you have to call VDR before the watchdog counter starts to overflow. Otherwise, it will cause a system reset or the interrupt, or both in some cases. Then they have the internal diagram. So if your separate 128 kilohertz oscillator, you have the watchdog prescaler going to a multiplexer, which is selected by the VDP bits from bit 3 to bit 0. And then we have the watchdog enable bit, the watchdog flag, the watchdog interrupt enable. Then that goes to an interrupt and also to an MCU reset. And then they have the watchdog always on, VDT on fuse, if programmed, will force the watchdog timer to system reset mode. With the fuse program, the system reset mode bit, VDT, and interrupt mode, watchdog interrupt enable, are locked to 1 and 0 respectively to further ensure program security. Alterations to the watchdog setup must follow a timed sequence. The sequence of clearing the VDE bit and changing the timeout configuration is as follows. In the same operation, write a logic 1 to the VDCE bit. Now the VDC bit is the watchdog change enable, and the VDE bit, which is watchdog enable bit. A logic 1 must be written to VDE regardless of the previous value of the VDE bit. So you must always, when you want to change anything to the watchdog timer, you need to write the watchdog change enable and VDE. And VDE must always be 1 when you want to change stuff. And then within 4 clock cycles, so immediately after you have written this sequence, write VDE and watchdog prescaler bits as desired, but with the VDCE bit cleared. Okay, so anything you want to change to the watchdog timer after writing the above sequence, then you just need the watchdog change enable bit always 0 when you write it. Then they have an assembler code example of how to turn off the watchdog timer. Then we have a C example. This we are going to lift straight into our code and modify it as we need to turn the watchdog timer off. And then we have another code example of how to change the prescaler, so the time that it takes to time out and reset the chip. And then we have the register descriptions for the entire section 10. There is an interesting register, but not really relevant to what we are going to do. We have the MCU status register, and this register, as long as you keep power to the chip, it will basically give you a reset cause from the chip. If you have a watchdog reset, then it will set bit 3. If you have a brownout reset, it will set bit 2. We have external reset, which is most probably the reset line if you pull that low, and then the power on reset, set, which is basically you cut power to the 80 mega 328p. Then we have the registers we are interested in. We have the watchdog timer control register. The first bit is a interrupt flag. So the watchdog interrupt flag, if this bit is high and interrupt has occurred on the watchdog. We have the VDIE bit, which is the watchdog interrupt enable. You write a 1 to this and you enable interrupts. Then you enable the watchdog timer to trigger an interrupt first and then reset the chip. And then we have a table of how the bits are set up. We have our configuration fuse here, which is VDT on, which is either 1 or 0. And then we have VDE, which is our watchdog enable, and then VDIE, which is our watchdog interrupt enable. When VDE on is not set, it is hard set to a system reset mode. I believe it is possible to run to enable the watchdog timer while this bit is not set, but then you're hard set to only the system reset mode. But we are going to use the system reset mode anyways with the VDT on bit enabled. Then you have all your other configurations that you can use, like the stop, which we are going to use to disable the watchdog timer. And then we have interrupt mode, which only triggers an interrupt once the watchdog expires. And then we have interrupt and system reset mode, which interrupt, you do whatever you need to do before the system resets. And then we have bit 4, which is the watchdog change enable. And basically you set this bit to 1 when you want to change something. And then the next set of instructions within 4 clock cycles, you have to write a 1 to this bit and whatever you want to change. And then we have the watchdog system reset enable. You write a 1 to this, you enable the watchdog. You write a 0 to this, you disable the watchdog. And then we have the prescaler selection bits, and from bit 0 to 3, and we have the table. Basically you use these values to set the time, so anywhere between 6 milliseconds to 8 seconds. The one we are going to use is 2 seconds, so 7 in decimal. Okay, so now that's the data sheet covered. Now let's get to the coding. Okay, so I have a base code here. I'm just going to comment this out because I'm not going to use it. I'm just sitting here that I'm aware of it. Okay, we have a print buffer, prints out whatever we wanted to print out. We're not really going to use it. We have a constant char string just to indicate our program has started. We set the 2 bits for the LEDs as output. Then we blink the 2 LEDs in sequence. Then we initialize our UART at board 9600. We enable our interrupts. We send a string over our program start, which actually renders this redundant and useless. So I'm going to remove it. Then we have an infinite while loop, and this is just for demonstration purposes. We have a for loop that runs 15 times, blinking the LEDs in alternating fashion. First, we have the DPort 7 LED on, and we turn off the DPort 6 LED off. Then we wait 200 milliseconds. We turn the DPort 6 LED on and turn the DPort 7 LED off, and then we wait for 200 milliseconds. We do this 15 times, and then we break the infinite loop of while one, and then we just go into another while one. This is just simulating code getting stuck. Okay, then I created 2 files, one the .h file for the watchdog timer hole, and then the watchdog timer hole.c. Now in the C file, I'm going to lift the VDT off code, stick that in the .c file, and then we are going to lift the prescaler change function also from the data sheet. And then we're going to create another function which is going to be void, and that's going to be watchdog timer enable, and that's going to take void parameters. Okay, now in our .h file, we are going to add a hash define, and that's going to be vdr and underscore asm. It's going to be double underscore vol a tile double underscore, and it's going to be the command we are executing is vdr, actually lowercase vdr, so watchdog timer reset. And this is just a nice way to inject assembler into the code. So all this does is it resets the watchdog timer. Then we are going to implement a typedef for the watchdog timer timeouts. I have pre-prepped this, so you don't need to sit and watch me type this out. So it's a numerator. It starts at 0 and ends at 9. So this is just an easy method to set the watchdog timer's prescaler. So it maps out the prescaler for us according to a time in seconds. And now we're going to modify the watchdog timer off function to take in a uint 8 underscore t, and that's going to be int enable. So this is going to determine if we have interrupts enabled or not. Now you can read the status register to check if the interrupts are enabled. I prefer to do it manually. First thing we do is we say if int enable not equals 0, then we say CLI, so we disable the interrupts. Then watchdog timer reset is going to be the VDR we defined here. Then we can keep this as is. And we keep this as is, and then we take this bit, add it in, and that's going to be SEI to enable the interrupts. And now we have the interrupts enabled, if the interrupts were enabled in the first place. Okay, so basically, this turns the entire watchdog timer off. This is nice for when you initialize code and stuff like that, and you don't have code running in the while. So you don't have a watchdog timer randomly reset because you forgot to reset the timer or anything like that. So let's just recap the function. We have watchdog timer off. We tell it, do you want to modify the interrupts, the state of the interrupts? Yes or no. 0 is no. Any other number is yes. Then we reset the watchdog timer. We clear the watchdog timer reset flag in the MCU status register. Then we enable the watchdog timer change, and then we clear the entire watchdog timer. So in our enable, first thing we do is clear the watchdog timer. We clear the flag for the watchdog timer, and then we just call the change interrupt. Then we OR that with the VDIE enable bit. So we turn the watchdog timer on. And then we have our prescaler, and we are going to lift the int enable here as a parameter. And then we are going to add our type def here, which is the VDT timeout E, and we are going to set that as time out. Okay, now we lift again the interrupt disable from the VDT off. Then we call the watchdog timer reset command, and then we lift the interrupt enable again. Now we have the change sequence here again, which is our change enable and watchdog enable, and then we have the function like this. Now we actually don't need to set each bit individually, so we can erase this and then just take timeout, copy, so move from the 0 bit. Move that up into the timeout, and then we also write a enable to that. So once you call the prescaler change, it will change the prescaler and enable the watchdog timer, so it also turns on the watchdog timer once you change the prescaler. So it's first off, change prescaler, prescaler turns it on. You have an optional to enable the watchdog timer separately. Then we have to add these functions to our header file. We add our off, and then we just do a test compile to check if everything works. Okay, we have a working thing. Okay, so first thing we do is we call watchdog timer, and we are going to call off for our function. We pass in 0 because we do not want to enable interrupts or disable interrupts. Then we call watchdog timer prescaler change. Actually, I want to quickly lowercase this. We have a 0 here, and then we take our enumerator defines, and then we're going to set the timeout to 2 seconds. Okay, then we have a for loop that blinks 3 times. Now notice the delays. So we have a 400 millisecond delay times 3. So this is going to be 4 times 3, which is 1200 milliseconds. Now note this is under the amount of time that the watchdog timer resets. And then we're going to initialize. So this should not trigger the watchdog timer in any sense. Now do we have the UART sends and the interrupt enables? This may trigger the watchdog timer. It may not trigger the watchdog timer, but I'm pretty sure this executes in under 8 milliseconds, since we are not resetting the watchdog timer at all in this sequence. Okay, then we have a for loop which executes 15 times. So that's going to be 15 times 4. Let me get my calculator out. This loop is going to take 6 seconds total. 6,000 milliseconds. Now note this is greater than the watchdog timer. So we are going to reset the watchdog at the end of each loop. So at the end of each one of these loops, we reset the watchdog timer, then we break the loop after we've exited this loop, and then we go into a while one. Now this while one doesn't do anything. It is literally just there to simulate, say your code gets stuck in a while one and it doesn't want to exit out of it, or some hardware failure or something caused a communication error and it is not recovering from that communication error. We save this, we just quickly compile, check it, happy compiler. Now something to note in the programming section, we have the fuses. We're auto reading, and you can see the fuse by default. If you have a chip that you got from Arduino or any of their bootloaders, this chip is by default set that the watchdog on bit fuse is not set. In order for this code to work, you need to set the VDT on fuse on the 80Mega328P, and then you can just program that in. Okay, so that's your fuses set, and then we can program the chip. Okay, now fair warning, if you are photosensitive, it is flashing green and red lights. Now you can see I'm holding the 80Mega328P in reset. We have the two LEDs here. So first they're gonna blink, 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 and then they're going to alternate between the two. And then one is going to get stuck, and then the watchdog timer is going to reset it after 2 seconds. So here we have the initial blink, the alternating blink for 15. Then we wait for that to finish. There's the reset, so that's going to be one. Okay, and then we're going to run again, and I'm just going to count it out. 1, 2, and reset. So actually, technically, what you need to do is you need to count from, let's say, 0, 1, 2. Okay. So my timing is a bit off, but you always have to start 0, 1, 2. And that's an introduction to using the watchdog timer on an 80Mega328P. A like, share, comment, and subscribe will always be appreciated. The code will be available on Git. There's some social links if you want to have a look at them in the description. Thank you. Have a nice day.